Our next guests, as well as being unstoppable musical juggernauts, in their spare time they also volunteer as coaches to our acts. It's only Dolores or Weirdin and Bressie. Yeah!
Yay! Yay! Woo! Yay!
Ooh, she's delighted and excited to be here. I can see Dolores.
Yeah.
John, we haven't asked you. So how are you finding the voice in general? How are you finding the experience? Because we're two live shows in. I think when you were announced, a lot of people were like, she's a very interesting choice. I wasn't even sure she'd do it.
I'm embracing it because, you know, I've lived in a bubble most of my life and surrounded myself by a kind of a security thing. And I haven't really stepped out of that bubble, so this is the first time in my life I've stepped out of the bubble.
Is this a threatening, scary bubble?
Does anybody have some Kleenex?
How is it as a bubble?
No, it's actually really cool because I live in the forest and all that kind of thing.
She does live in the forest.
I do live in the forest.
Do you actually live in the forest?
In the middle of the woods, look out the window, there's bears, raccoons, wolves, you name it. Seriously,
I live in the
forest.
That's how you guys bonded, isn't it?
Because I live in the forest.
No, you don't live in a forest, but didn't Dolores ask you to go for a walk to hug some trees or something one time?
I've heard of tree hugging, I just thought it was an expression, but no, she actually meant hug trees.
Yeah, okay.
So I was grand, but most.
Actually, did you not feel good about it though afterwards?
Amazing.
I know it sounds a bit weird and out there and hippie, wacky, whatever. But when you embrace that tree, you feel the power of the earth and the significance of life in itself, you know?
Embrace tree. Anyone out there, go hug a tree and it'll all be in perspective. Now, let's talk about this evening. There was a lot of people unhappy across the board with different coaches' comments at different times. Do we feel that we're being consistent across the board, Bressie?
I mean, you're always going to get... Like, the tweets that I get after a show, like, they range from the most... almost, like, hilariously... ridiculous,
violent and aggressive,
violent,
and hateful.
It's a TV show.
Yeah,
chill out. You know, and then some of the tweets are quite constructive, and you listen to them, and you. But I think, in fairness, overall, we're consistent. We're, you know, at the end of the day, we've never said we make perfect decisions all the time.
Yeah,
but we do mess up, and you know, sometimes we don't. But we don't have any bad intentions with it.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
all we're all just trying to think who could win the show. That's the end of the day. It's all we're trying to do.
Dolores, you lost Peter tonight.
Uh-huh.
Now he was one of the few who got all four to turn. Am I correct in the blinds?
Mm-hmm.
He was a very popular choice. Do you think, like you said, he has one of those voices that splits the room? Do you think it was the song that let him down, or?
No, you know, he's to me once himself. He said, I don't really think I have a great box. He said to me once, you know. So and what he
voice.
Does is he lacks confidence. Really, that's his downfall. And going forward in life, you know, it's important to have confidence because you only live once. And so it's his confidence that holds him back a lot, you know, and yeah, so I think like if he kind of, you know, dealt with that a little bit, it'd be good. And there's so many powerful girls that are really confident and like...
He needs to start.
Is this show all about the girls? That's what Laura said. It says this
they,
is...
They kicked ass tonight, big time. Yeah, I just noticed that at the end. I was like, yeah, I think today, like the girls had really, really strong vocals. And you know, there is the confidence issues you're getting that people have. But I think to be fair, at this stage, most of them have got rid of them and they're actually, I'm telling them to get excited. A live show you should be excited about. I know there's going to be an element of nerves, but no, I think the girls really stepped up tonight.
Okay. Dolores, you're on Twitter, but you're not on Twitter. Is that correct? You have a Twitter account, but it's not you.
No.
No, don't like
it's
that world.
Pope.
No, I don't know much about it. Where is it? I can't see it.
It's in the ether. It kind of floats all around us.
I know. Well, it's kind of like, I don't know, it's like another dimension. And it's like this other dimension. No, you ever read the book Falun Gong?
Yep.
Says that the world was exploded 9 times, planet Earth. And there is a fresco in a cave in Peru that's 30,000 years old, and it's a fresco of a man looking through a telescope.
And that's
now,
where
how
Dolores
did they know about that 30,000 years ago? Only if the world existed 9 times? Seriously, read it, Falun Gong.
Done.
I'm going to put it on my to-do list.